Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Breaking news just coming in the last hour, and I'm going to break you guys for the channel. Fabrizio Romano, he's been great with the transfers over, not just Celtic, but over any transfer, really, he's the main man to go to. And for Celtic, he's getting there with, you know, the transfers coming true. Celtic have reached an agreement with Rubin, Kazan to sign Starfelt from the title. It's a done deal, and here we go. Finally, we've got a done deal. Fabrizio Romano has tweeted it. $5 million as final fee. Negotiations completed. Next target, obviously, is Brandon Sobey, the right back. Also sees in it, puts in his tweet, official announcement soon for Starfelt. Personal terms agreed as advanced 1 week ago. Sweden international car stuff is due in Moscow soon to undergo a medical ahead of a move to Celtic. Another centre back in the door, hopefully, potentially by maybe tomorrow, if he's done his medical, by today maybe. Celtic's transfer, Carl Starfelt, he's a strong ball player and playing centre back that helped Rubin Kazan to fourth in Russia. They also had the joint second best defensive record in the league. Is he good? The big question, obviously, going to be, is he good enough for Celtic? I think coming from that record of they also had the joint second best defensive record in the league. I know it wasn't just Carl Starfelt, but being one of the centre backs, you know, you're going to be in there, you know, defensive. And I think Carl Starfelt is going to be a good sign, because you've only got 6 days to go for this Michelin game, and if we can get Starfelt in the door, it would be great, because the way you're looking up for this Champions League qualifier, you know, Welsh, Beaton at the back. I don't fancy Beaton at the back. I don't really fancy Welsh at the back, really, but I guess he's going to have to do, because it looks like we're only going to send one centre-back, but hopefully we do get Brandon Sobey over the line for a right-back. The club already signed Liam Shaw and Zazie Ardegiri. Both of them, obviously, youngsters, and might not be ready to come in and immediately establish themselves in the first team. Hoops will need to bring in some experienced players through with the Champions League qualifiers not far away, only 6 days away. There are a number of positions in the squad that still need to be filled, really, like Austin Edouard, potentially even Chris Ayer. Somehow started rejected $15 million from him. Potentially, only a month ago, we were saying that he's only going to get $7 or $8 million. Double that and we're rejecting it. I mean, that's crazy for Celtic. And Ryan Christie could be headed for the exit door soon. Amidst all this, Celtic have managed to reach an agreement, as I said in the start of the video, for Rubin Kazan defender Carl Starfelt. Negotiations are completed and the final fee is set to be around $5 million, while personal terms have already been agreed earlier. That was from transfer expert Fabrizio Romano tweeted out. But Starfelt can be a great sign for Celtic, because he can be a great fit for Postecoglou's side of football. He's a ball-playing centre-back with some most expressive passing in the Russian Premier League. He's good at defensive duels too, and does not give away fouls easily, which we like. I hate centre-backs that just give away fouls in stupid positions. It's just daftness, and you can see goals from it. It's just rubbish. Starfelt was a very impressive last season campaign, as Rubin Kazan finished fourth in the Russian Premier League with one of the best defences in the entire league. The arrival of Starfelt could also give Celtic the opportunity to resolve the future of Ayer, who has only 1 year left in his current deal. The Hoops are believed to already reject the big offers from the Norwegian international this summer, but that might have been because of the absence of a replacement from his squad, potentially. Potentially we're waiting on this coming. But you could have said was it Brentford or something who were offering $14 or $15 million, could we wait until we maybe... Can you wait, just hold on until we get Starfelt? You know, maybe they didn't want that, you know. They want to die on the door right away. Starfelt could be a very well be that replacement. The 26-year age, very good age for a defender. He has some solid experience having played in top flight football in both Sweden and Russia. According to the stats from Transfer Market, he has made 42 appearances for Rubin Kazan until now. Before that, he played for IF Broma Karana and IFK Goldberg. He also represented the Swedish national team on 3 occasions. Carl Starfelt will fly to Moscow today and undergo a medical before signing a 4-year deal with Celtic. So, breaking news this morning, guys. 14th of July, first real sign under Ange Postecoglou will go ahead. Celtic reach agreement with Rubin Kazan to sign Carl Starfelt guys. So please subscribe and like, guys. And if you have enjoyed the video, make sure to share the subscribe and like and share the video as per usual. Recent views on channel at 1,100 subs, which is great. I try and post the best content for you guys every day. Just Celtic related news and transfer talk. This is going to obviously transfer talk because it's reached an agreement with Rubin Kazan to sign Starfelt. So before I go, guys, I've got to do it because it's a traditional thing, innit? But you guys, if you have enjoyed the videos, yeah, make sure to subscribe and like and share them out, of course. You made Sky Sports. Celtic have reached an agreement with Rubin Kazan to sign Carl Starfelt from, as I said, Rubin Kazan. Fabrizio Romano, very high rated transfer journalist, he said, negotiation completed, 5 million as final fee, official announcement soon for Starfelt, personal terms agreed as advanced 1 week ago. That's me, Jim White, subscribe to 07. Peace.